Good morning, students. Let's understand the second set of tenses, that is past. In this set of tenses, first we begin with simple past tense. Before we go in a detail about the sentence structures of simple past tense, first let's see the use of simple past tense. The first use of the simple past tense is to express a past event. Whenever we want to show a past event or a past action, we use simple past tense. Even that past event or that past action does not have any relation in present. For example, India got its freedom in 1947. He scored 95% last year. These are the examples of simple past tense. First use, express a past event. Second use, to show for past habit. To describe past habits, we have to use simple past tense. Simple present tense we use to describe the habitual actions or for habits which are in present. But to describe the past habits, we have to use the simple past tense. For example, I played cricket. It means now I am not playing. I played cricket. I played piano. That is also showing past habit. He smoked in the absence of his parents. So that's showing her past habit, and we have used simple past tense to describe it. Another use, that is to express an action which lasted for period of time in the past. Students, if you remember, present perfect tense and present perfect continuous tense, these two tenses we use to describe the action which started in the past and continuing in the present. But to express an action which lasted for a period of time in the past, to describe that action we use simple past tense. For example, I worked in the Salvation Army English Medium School for 3 years. It means the time duration of past it was mentioned, and to describe that action I have used the simple past tense. He served in the multinational company for 10 years. Here also we can see the time duration for 10 years and the action that was of past. He served in the multinational company for 10 years. So to express an action which lasted for period of time in the past, we have to use the simple past tense. Other uses are also there, that in when clauses, it means in adverb clause of time also, when we want to describe the past action, we have to use the simple past tense. For example, when I reached home, I found the house locked. In this sentence, both the clauses, when clause and the main clause, both are in simple past tense. Now we know more about the simple past tense. In simple past tense, we use V2. In simple past tense, we use V2. V2, it means the second form of the verb. Second form of the verb, it means past form of the verb. So in simple past tense, we use V2. Another thing, that to make negative and interrogative sentences, we use did as a helping verb. If you remember, in simple present tense, to make negative and interrogative sentences, we use do and does as helping verb. In simple past tense, to make negatives and interrogatives, we use helping verb did. And when we use did, please listen it and remember. And when we use did as helping verb in negative and in interrogative, that time we are removing V2 and we have to use V1. Now let's see the sentence structure for simple past tense. First, sentence structure of affirmative sentence. The sentence structure of affirmative sentence is subject, V2 plus other words and full stop. See here, subject, V2, other words and full stop. For example, he finished his work yesterday. Here he is subject, finished V2, his work yesterday, other words and full stop. Now sentence structure for negative, subject, helping verb did, plus not, plus V1, plus other words and full stop. See here, sentence structure for negative sentence. Subject, did, not, V1, other words and full stop. See here, V1. In affirmative sentence, we use V2. In simple past tense, we use V2, second form of the verb, that is past form of the verb. But in interrogative and in negative sentence, we use helping verb did. And when we use helping verb did, we remove V2 and we use V1, that is the present form of the verb. So sentence structure for negative, I repeat, subject, did, not, V1 and other words, full stop. See the negative of this sentence. He did not finish his work yesterday. See students, for negative we have used did as helping verb, we have used not. Now here, instead of finished, we have used finish. That finish, it is V1 and other words and full stop. Here we have to remember students, in negative of simple past tense, we use helping verb did. So when we use did, we have to remove past form of the verb and we have to use V1, that is present form of the verb. Again and again I am telling you that in simple past tense, when we use did, we have to remove the past form of the verb. It means we have to remove V2 and we have to use V1, means present form of the verb. Because this is the area whereby most of the students make mistake. So this you remember, when we use did as helping verb for making negative and interrogative, we use V1. Now let's see the sentence structure of an interrogative sentence and affirmative of simple past tense. The sentence structure is did, then subject, then V1, then other words, and at last question mark. Once again, see here, did, subject, V1, other words and question mark. Here also remember, as it is interrogative sentence, so we use helping verb did, so we have to use V1. See the example, did he finish his work yesterday? Here see, we have used did, so here we have used finish, not finished. We have used here V1, not V2. Next sentence structure, that is interrogative negative sentence. The sentence structure is did, subject, not, V1, other words, and at last question mark. Once again look here, did, subject, not v1, other words and question 1. I repeat, when we use did in interrogative sentence, any negative sentence of simple past tense, we remove v2 and we use v1. So the negative interrogative sentence is, did he not finish his work yesterday? Here see, did negative showing or negation showing word not and v1 finish. Did he not finish his work yesterday? Students, in negative interrogative, we can use even the contraction form of did not, that is didn't. We can write in this way also. Didn't he finish his work yesterday? In all negative interrogatives of all the tenses, we can use contraction. We can use the contraction. Means a short form of a did not, does not, do not, will not, shall not, was not, were not, is not, are not. That we can use for negative interrogative sentence. Did he not finish his work yesterday? Correct. Didn't he finish his work yesterday? That is also correct. Thank you, students.